The mechanical flower can be operated manually, or you can just gently set it in this base. Plug it in, push the button, and it provides a nice, smooth, constant speed mechanical display. Now we'll look at some of the other components and parts that are in the base. I'm making another one of these motor adapter spindles, only this time I'm using Delrin. Delrin is extremely easy to machine, and it is certainly strong enough for this application. We need to mount the drive spindle on the motor on a shelf and adjust that height up and down until this drive spindle matches to the mechanical flower perfectly. I made a shelf out of 1/4-inch ply, and I will bevel this to match this inside taper and continue to gradually reduce the diameter of that so this can go down there a little bit further. And I'll put that spindle in there. Do a trial fit of the mechanical flower until I have everything adjusted perfectly. Combination of two pieces of 1/2-inch plywood, some 1/8-inch plywood, and some cardboard. Shim this shelf to the right position. When I put these fingers in here, I know that shelf will be parallel to this plane. I want to mark these locations for the motor on this piece of plywood. Put some alcohol on the plywood and we'll push that down. There, 4 locations. This is why you keep a junk drawer or a junk box. When I scrap out a piece of electrical equipment or anything, I salvage all the metric screws and that and go around through here, and I can usually find enough to mount one of these motors or something else that shows up with metric threads. And this sorting tray, I've covered that in one of my videos. This is real handy. Put it all back in the bottle. The mechanical flower is sitting on the base. It engages with these 3 pins. Once I get that shelf adjusted to the correct height, I put 3 little fingers in here for this shelf to attach to, and you have to make sure that those clear the feet on the base. 1 screw here, here, and 1 underneath this piece, and they're on 120-degree spacing. This is ready to wire. The motor is installed. This is a relay, and this is the Arduino Nano. Power input will plug in here, and this is a normally open push button. The concept here is you plug this in, this wakes up. When you push the button, it will time how long this motor runs. I've got 12-volt DC coming from my power supply. It runs the Nano and also this relay. The motor will pull too much current to run it through the Nano. So the Nano turns on the relay turns on the motor, and the Nano and the motor are running off the power supply. And this cutout is here so I can tighten the set screw that holds this onto the motor shaft. Connect the power supply, the Nano wakes up. When we push the buttons, The LEDs on the Nano and the relay come on. The LED on the relay tells you the solid state relay is closed, and the motor will run for 53,000 milliseconds, or 53 seconds. The LEDs go out, and the motor has stopped. This unit has a 3 RPM gear motor, and this unit a 2 RPM gear motor. This, on a power supply by itself, will run 5 complete cycles, give or take, and this, 7 complete cycles. With them both connected to the same power supply, that will slow down the motors a little bit. If you're interested in one of these, please go to the website link that's in the description for this video, and it will help support this channel, not only for the purchase of this item, but for any of the UGear products through the link in the description. Now I just need to finish the bases. Whether you have watched a video before or not, no harm in watching it again. You may have missed something, and it will help support this channel. Thank you for watching. Please tell your friends about my channel. I appreciate it.